two people are badly injured in a local roadway shut down after an accident in Lake County. Good afternoon, I'm Aixa Diaz.
And I'm Jason Guy. Two cars and a semi crashed around 8:30 this morning on Buck Hill Road and County Road 455 in Claremont. WESH 2's Gail Pascal Brown is live at the scene with all the breaking details. What can you tell us, Gail?
I can tell you that the road has been shut down since 8:30 this morning when this crash happened. And right now, there's a Lake County Fire Rescue as well as other authorities trying to get this big semi towed. Now, it could take another hour or two to get it cleared along with the other cars off the road. The semi at this time was loading sand. Two people were carrying sand, rather. Two people were flown to the hospital. One is in critical condition at ORMC. The Florida Highway Patrol says 19-year-old Mark Thibodeau of Claremont was stopped at a stop sign at Buck Hill Road. Just south of County Road 455 in a Honda Civic. The semi was eastbound and then veered to the left to avoid hitting the Claremont man as he entered the intersection. Now, the front of the semi hit Thibodeau, and the impact caused a trailer of the semi to fall right on top of a third car, a Subaru. It crushed the Subaru. Now, the unidentified female driver was taken to ORMC, and she is listed in critical condition. The semi's driver, Glenn Davis, is out here. He's of Polk County, and he was not injured. Back on camera now, you can see they're still working this scene, trying to get all of these vehicles, you know, getting off the road. And if you can see the cab there, Glenn Davis's cab, it's got like a lot of oil on it. Well, when he ran over, or when his the trailer crushed that Subaru, it basically just splattered his oil pan, and that's why all of that is up there as it is right now. But again, two people were taken to the hospital. One is in critical condition, the other is in serious condition. And as far as a driver, I tried to talk to him, Glenn Davis of the semi, and right now he doesn't want to speak with us. FHP is still investigating this crash, and as soon as I touch bases again with them, we'll find out exactly who's going to be charged in this. I'm Gail Pascal Brown, live in Lake County for WESH 2 News.